He's back to pass. Pressure coming. He's going to get hit in the end zone. That's going to be a safety.
It's now time for Gridiron State of the Union.
Another touchdown for the Ridge, and they've gone up. The score is 23-17.
Presented by DMR Reconstruction, North Carolina's leader in quality insurance restoration services. With crews on standby 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, DMR Reconstruction has your restoration needs covered. Give them a call at 704-327-4028.
He's going to hand it off to Byram. Byram on the right-hand side. He's going to be into the end zone. Touchdown, Monroe.
Gridiron State of the Union is your insider's look each week into Union County High School football.
Marshall fires one off, and it's into the end zone. Touchdown, Piedmont.
Now we head into the DMR Reconstruction Studio and your host, Brian Stevenson.
Regular season is over, and now the playoffs begin. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Gridiron State of the Union. I'm Brian Stevenson. Last week saw Monroe win the rivalry game against Forest Hills, and Cufferson claim the Southern Carolina Conference crown. Those are the headlines this week as we kick off our playoff edition. Eight teams are in the playoffs on Friday night, and later in the show, Sideline Mike and I will break down all of the games. But right now, let's review what happened last week and let you know who is playing this week in our trip around Union. And we start off with Sideline Mike and that WIXC Game of the Week.
Our WIXC Game of the Week features the Monroe Redhawks hosting the T.W. Andrews Red Raiders. The game is a rematch of last year's state championship game. Monroe is coming off of a victory last week on the road at rival Forest Hills. The Redhawks won 34-8. Senior Chase Byram had a big night for Monroe, racking up 145 yards and two scores. Donovan Black also had over 100 yards and two scores. No doubt the Redhawks will have that disappointing state championship loss in Chapel Hill on their minds when they take the field. But the only reward the winner gets this time will be a trip to round two. You can catch that big rematch right here on the Mighty 1190, beginning with the pregame at 7 p.m., kickoff is at 7:30. Now let's go to Reed Alexander with Game 2 of our doubleheader.
Game 2 of our WIXC doubleheader features a 3AA matchup between the number 5 seed Weddington Warriors hosting the number 12 seed South Iredell Vikings. The Warriors finished the regular season by handling Marvin Ridge 37-10. Weddington enters the playoffs with a 10-1 record. The Warriors' only loss of the season coming at the hands of Cutherson. A win this Friday would tie the school record for wins. To get to round two, though, they will have to defeat a South Iredell team that has made deep playoff runs in the past, but has had a down year by their standards. The Vikings come into Friday night with a 6-5 record. Tune in to this first-round matchup immediately following game number one right here on WIXC. Now, let's send it to Chris Rogers.
The Sun Valley Spartans finally snapped a three-game skid last Friday night by beating Anson County 49-15. What's more important is it was done at home. Albert Funderburk crossed the 2,000-yard mark for the second straight year. Sun Valley's number 14 seed in 3A and will travel to face number 3 Statesville this week. The Greyhounds are 7-4 overall and on a three-game win streak as well. The Spartans feel good about their chances with only one road loss this season. Next up, Marvin Ridge at Ashboro. Although they only had three wins, the three wins is what got them in the playoffs. Starting their season 0-7, but four of those losses were by 6 points or less. The Mavericks then rattled off three straight conference wins. They lost last week to Weddington 37-10. But Coach Brad Hoover has his team believing. Friday night they face the 8-3 Blue Comets of Ashboro High School. The Blue Comets have won 7 of their last 8 games and will be a tough round one opponent. Now let's go to Ken Ogden.
The Cutherson Cavaliers ran the table in the Southern Carolina Conference, winning their first football conference championship in school history. The Cavaliers hung on to beat Piedmont last week 32-29 and are on a 7-game win streak. This has been a special season for Cutherson with quarterback Austin Kendall throwing for over 3,000 yards. They earned the number 2 seed in the Western 3A bracket and will host the number 15 seed Green Wave of Ashbrook High School. The Green Wave come into Waxhaw with a 5-6 record. Next up, the Forest Hills Yellow Jackets. The Jackets lost last week to Monroe 34-8. The loss will drop Forest Hills to the number 10 seed and cause them to travel for West Stokes, who was number 7 seed. Coach Lowry always has his team ready for the playoffs.
South Robeson travels to Union Academy for the first round of the 1A playoffs this week. Last week, Union Academy had a tough loss to North Stanley 42-10. The loss drops Union Academy to 5-6 overall. A win this week would give Union Academy 6 wins for the second season in a row. Next up, the Parkwood Rebels. The Cinderella story from last year's playoffs are back again this year, and their first round opponent will be a team they knocked off in that Cinderella run, the Hunter Huss Huskies. Last week, Parkwood beat Central Academy in the final regular season game 19-18. It took a fourth quarter comeback to get the win over Central, but the win improves Parkwood to 6-5 overall. Their opponent, Hunter Huss, comes into the game with a 4-7 record. When these two teams matched up in the playoffs last year, Parkwood came away with the win 21-14. That's the story on the Rebels, and now let's head back to the studio and Brian Stevenson.
Thanks a lot, Derek. We'll take a quick timeout, but when we come back, we'll review all of the first round matchups with Sideline Mike. Gridiron State of the Union, we'll be right back.
Thank you for tuning in and listening to the Gridiron State of the Union, brought to you exclusively by DMR Reconstruction. Fire, water, wind, or mold damage, they are your go-to source. And if you're thinking about remodeling from the tip top of the roof to the bottom of the foundation, they can handle it for you. Windows, doors, paint, floors, vinyl siding, they do it all at DMR Reconstruction. Stop by and visit their showroom on Highway 74 in Marshville, North Carolina. You'll be glad you did. 704-327-4028, 327-4028, and they hope you're enjoying the Gridiron State of the Union, brought to you by DMR Reconstruction.
Welcome back to Gridiron State of the Union. It's our playoff edition as we start round one this week, and I've got Sideline Mike with me. And Mike, I tell you what, we're just going to dive right into this thing. T.W. Andrews comes to Monroe, and this one I know Coach Sal and the boys are salivating about because it's a rematch of last year's state championship game.
Big time rematch coming up here, and when you look at it, it was a 4-point game, last possession of the ball game type game. And T.W. Andrews pulled it out in Chapel Hill. And as you mentioned, the boys at Monroe, they've been salivating, wanting T.W. Andrews back, wanting a little bit of revenge. And luckily, the Red Raiders, they have to make the trip to Red Hawk Stadium Friday night.
Yeah, obviously, they've had a rougher year. This is a team that's barely above 500. So, it's two different teams. This win doesn't win you a state championship. It only gets you to round two. But let's talk about Monroe a little bit, because here's a team that fell in a close game at Mount Pleasant, lost three other games in a regular season, had some injuries. But where do you see – you saw them last week. Where do you see these guys right now? Because Coach Sal seems to feel like they're back and ready to make a run.
Well, I'm one of these guys. I'm not real big on making excuses. But with that being said, Monroe's been bit by the injury bug quite a bit this year off and on. Last week, they were healthy. Coach Sal was happy with where his team was at, and, man, they looked like a well-oiled machine against Forest Hills. When you look at the regular season, the teams that they lost to and the teams that they beat, they lost to Weddington, which is you know, a kind of a powerhouse in their own right. They're really coming into their own. And they lost to Charlotte Christian, another big-time team around the area, as well as Mount Pleasant in that close 10-7 ball game you mentioned. But the win total, the win tally, when you look at the teams they beat, the one that sticks out the most, they beat Cuthbertson High School 35-21. Cuthbertson, the only team to knock off Weddington this year. So I think Monroe, as long as everybody comes in healthy, and I do believe they are, they've got a good shot.
Well, that's our game of the week, and certainly you'll have the call of that along with Shane Green. Now let's move a little more quickly through these next few. Our second game will be South Iredell at Weddington. Weddington's had a great season despite the slip-up with Cuthbertson. Here's a one-loss, 10-1 team, and they're right back where they were in the playoffs last year.
10-1 team, only lost by 4 points in the game that they lost. They're in the hunt, and Tim Carson's going to have this Weddington defense, which has been absolutely ferocious this year, ready for South Iredell.
South Iredell's down a little bit this year, but I've covered them a lot over the years for Football Friday Night. The Vikings are well-coached. And not a team you can overlook. Definitely a tough first-round opponent. South Robeson in the 1A is heading to Union Academy. Union Academy has had a good history of first-round games, especially when they're at home. And, of course, this one on Friday night there. Union Academy, you know, not too bad considering the coaching turnovers they've had in the last few years.
Union Academy comes in at 5-6 on the season. They could very easily be above 500, you know, but as you made mention, a couple of coaching changes, they've really come into their own, and they're working on things, and I look for good things for Union Academy this week as they face South Robeson.
And South Robeson at 3-8. Another game, Parkwood at Hunter Huss, the Cinderella story from last year, and they're going to have to be a Cinderella again. They're the 13th seed, but they're at Hunter Huss, a place that you went last year and saw them win 21-14 over the Huskies.
I had the call last year with Ronnie Hargett, and absolutely, it was a Cinderella story. With that being said, neither one of these teams are the same team that they were last year. I think Parkwood's got a good shot, but it's going to take absolutely everything that they've got to pull this one out. They've won some close ball games this year. I think it's going to be another close ball game they're going to be in Friday night.
Well, we will have all of the details on these games. Check out the scores on ucpreps.com. But we still got more playoff teams to examine, and we'll do that with Sideline Mike. You're listening to Gridiron State of the Union, and back in 60 seconds.
This quick break in the action is brought to you by DMR Reconstruction, the exclusive sponsor of the Gridiron State of the Union. One of these days, you're going to want to do home improvement. New windows, new doors. Maybe you got hardwood floors you want to refinish, or you need new carpet or flooring. DMR Reconstruction is your go-to source. They also specialize in fire, water, wind, and mold damage restoration. They'll even help you deal with the insurance companies. Visit the showroom in Marshville, North Carolina, or give them a call at 704-327-4000. 24/7 for emergencies, 327-4028. Let them know you heard about them here on Wixie. And now back to more of the Gridiron State of the Union, brought to you by DMR Reconstruction.
Welcome back to Gridiron State of the Union, our playoff edition here in round one. We've already gone through four of the teams that are playing. Let's pick up with Sun Valley at Statesville. Sun Valley really struggled in October, but finally snapped that skid last week. It's going to be a tough one, though. They've got to play the number three seed Greyhounds.
Number three seed Greyhounds, and Statesville is always one of those teams that are in the playoffs come first and the second round. Sun Valley comes in with Union County's all-time leading rusher. They're going to need him this Friday night against Statesville.
Yeah, definitely. And these guys have been great on the road, except for the close Cuthbertson loss. Let's hope they can go up there and knock off the Greyhounds. Marvin Ridge, the surprise of the playoffs. Three wins, but they were three critical wins in the conference. That gets them in as the 10 seed going up to Asheboro.
Coach Hoover told you before the season started that if those guys could just learn how to win and turn that corner, they would really be something. And they really have turned that corner. Conference time come. They've won three games in the conference, and it puts them in a position here in the playoffs to really be the Cinderella story that we seen Parkwood be last year. They're going to face a tough Asheboro team who's looking to make a statement in the playoffs themselves.
Forest Hills is up next. They've got to travel. They lost last week. That puts them on the road to West Stokes, a team that Monroe beat last year in the playoffs. It's a 10-7 matchup. I kind of like these when our guys are going into a 10-7 matchup.
Anytime you've got Johnny Lowry as a head coach, you've definitely got a shot at being in the ballgame. Forest Hills 5-6, another team that kind of turned the corner come playoff or conference time here. They've got to make the trip to King, North Carolina, and I'm with you, Brian. I kind of like our boys. Let's go Jackets.
Final one of the night. The best team, arguably, in Union County. They've beat everybody but Monroe, and they're on the hot streak, seven straight wins. Cuthbertson hosting the Green Wave of Ashbrook High.
Ashbrook High School and Cuthbertson. Coming on to looking at the playoff brackets, I was kind of hopeful that we would see this matchup. Ashbrook's a good football team. They've been playoff powerhouses for years. And Cuthbertson, as you made mention, king of the mountain. They've knocked off everybody in Union County. They're looking to make a statement. And I believe Coach Johnson's got the boys ready for a deep playoff run.
Thanks a lot, Mike. And we hope you'll tune in to Mike and Shane as they bring you Monroe against T.W. Andrews on Friday night.
Time for Extra Points.
In my Extra Points tonight, it's a new season for all eight teams now entering the playoffs. And that's what these guys have been training for ever since the 1st of August. We certainly wish them all the best of luck. We're all out of time for this edition of Gridiron State of the Union, but we have examined the state of our union, and I can report it is good. Good night, everybody.